in the last video we made the Mandalorian helmet. This time we're going to continue with the Beskar armor and make the chest and the shoulders. But before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the little notification bell. That way you'll be made aware of when I continue on with this project and post another video. And also make sure to give this video a thumbs up too. Done that? Well, let's get cracking.
So we start off cutting out the templates, printing these out onto A4 paper. And then once you've done that, trace them onto some foam mats. As you can see, we're starting off with one of the shoulder pieces. The inner detail line now I've cut only into the horizontal line, and then I'm going to draw around those to get the inner detail and then join those two lines up with a ruler to get that straight edge. You then cut out the piece for the side of the shoulder. Do not cut that detail piece off because it needs to be heat formed first. Once you've got the three pieces for each one cut, you're going to use a heat gun on the high setting to heat this from the back, and you're going to curve it into shape. I started this by curving it on the edge of my table, and then once the foam was cool enough to handle, shape the rest of it by hand. And then you're going to do the same thing, heat form the bit that goes down the middle, just to give that a bit of a curve. Once the pieces are curved, you can cut that detail line out. Make sure you've got a very sharp knife to give you nice clean cuts. And then that piece that you're left with, the big piece, you need a little bit of a trim to be cut into that on two of the edges. So I'm cutting halfway down and halfway into the foam like this. And that's on the bottom edge. Glue then on the bottom edge of that and then set that slightly back from the outer detail trim. Do one edge at a time to make sure it's nice and aligned so you can hold each piece as it's setting. The bit that goes down the middle, I glued one end on first, let that completely set. And then did the same thing to the other end, held that in place while that completely set. As you can see, it's oversized here, so I can trim it to shape after it's all glued together. And then using some tape, I taped that into place down the middle. And then glued it from the back. And once that was 100% dry, I did that to the other side too. Once that's completely set, bit of heat on the underside, and then curve that into shape, being careful not to put too much heat on those seams or they just pull apart, and then peel the tape off. Do the exact same thing for the other shoulder, and then once you've done that, you're gonna need to cut out the Mudhorn logo. And this was then traced onto 2mm craft foam and cut out with a really sharp knife. This is quite fiddly, this bit, so make sure you take your time. Using the template to get the positioning, I mark the tip of the horn and various parts of the skull with pins. And then I can line up the foam pieces to those pins to make sure I've got it in the right position. Bit of hot glue on the back, making sure to go right to the edge of the craft foam, because when you're heat sealing this later, if there's any edges that aren't glued down, they'll lift up and curve up and look horrible. So make sure this is glued right to the very edge. Once you've done this, it's time to heat seal these and they are ready to paint. So the paint here is three parts silver to one part black. Just mix those together thoroughly. And then I apply this with a soft bristle brush to minimize brush strokes. Once the first coat of paint is completely dry, I went on and put two more coats on. These were then sealed with a clear lacquer. Onto the chest. So same again. Paper templates printed onto A4 paper. There's a little scale thing at the top of the page that you can compare to your ruler to make sure you've got these the right size. And then starting off with one of these chest pieces, draw around that, then put the center piece in, pin that down, and then that chest piece, you're gonna unpin that and flip that over so you've got the whole chest as one big piece. And then draw around that. If you cut these parts out separately, they might not join together 100% correctly. So if you do it like this, so the all is one big piece, and then you cut that middle piece out later, they'll definitely join up correctly. This bit here, you need to add a piece onto the end, just like this. And that'll become clear in a moment why you do that. And this piece, the same as the chest, you draw around it and then flip it over to get the other side. The diagonal lines on this, I make sure I get nice and straight by using a ruler. And just like with the other side, I added on that extra piece in the corner too. This next piece, draw around as normal, making sure you've got a lot of space around the edge, because this needs a trim around the edge too. So I just use the thickness of my ruler to give this a border. When cutting out the chest, you're going to need to have your knife angled slightly to give it a bevel. You're going to cut with the knife facing inwards and then make this bevel even more exaggerated by cutting off some extra foam on the back. You only need to do this on the outside edge where the other pieces attach. You don't need to do this on the bottom or the top. They can stay completely flat. So that piece we added, just like we did with the shoulder, we're going to cut halfway down and halfway into the foam. And that's going to give us a little recessed piece that's going to help us attach this to the chest later on. Those diagonal lines have been cut at an angle, and then that angle on one piece has been cut off, so then you'll be able to stick those back together at about a 45 degree angle. This piece here is done in exactly the same way, cut at an angle, and then the angled piece is cut off so they can be stuck together, creating that bevel. The chest is heated from the back and ever so slightly curved. I made sure I held this up to my own body to get the rough contour of my own chest. And once that's curved, it's then cut into the three pieces that we traced it out from. Make sure you curve this before you cut it, otherwise it won't line up as nice. The template for that middle piece, the outer edge is then cut off, and we're drawing around that middle piece on another piece of foam. If you've got thinner foam, then that'll work out better, because this needs to be cut down to about half its thickness, so you're looking for about 4 or 5 mil thick. Why I do this is to just cut around the edge, then lay it down, and then almost like you're filleting a fish, just run that knife down the length of it to cut that nice and thin. Cutting those detail bits in the top and bottom of this now, this kind of V-shaped groove with a really sharp blade. Just taping up the pieces from the front, making sure they cover every part of the seam, because the way I like to glue my pieces together is to tape them up from the front and then glue them from the back. This usually results in really neat seams, provided that you tape them together really neatly. So these were the parts ready for assembly for the chest. So this center part is going to be glued on its top edge, and it's set slightly back from the main chest pieces on either side. So do one side first, making sure it's nice and even, and then do the same for the other side. Using pins again to mark where I want this part to go, putting them at the points and corners, and then lots of glue on the back of this, and then using those pins to get the position right and lay that down nice and straight. There's a tiny little rectangular piece that goes on the inside of this detail in the middle too, and that's set slightly above center. So as before, these parts are taped on from the front, making sure to cover every part of the seam, otherwise your glue will seep out the front, and then gluing this from the back. You might need to pull these parts ever so slightly apart to make sure the glue goes all the way to the front of the seam. Just be careful your hot glue doesn't burn through your tape too. Once those side pieces are completely set, stick on these next parts as well from the front, and then glue those from the back. If they need to be glued at a certain angle, hold them at the angle they need to be set at while the glue is drying. This is the part we added the extra bit around the outside. Before that's glued on, you're going to need to rough up the back of this part of a rasp file. And then that's glued along that edge there, and it's set on the part you drew round, not the bit the you added on, but the part you drew round. Use that as a guide, and the extra bit you added on is just where the glue goes and holds that in nice and straight and nice and strong. So this again is going to need to be roughed up before you glue these on, and these are just rectangle strips, same thickness as my ruler that I've cut out. I've made one, I'm cutting this one to the exact same size. And they're just going to be stuck in there, so there's not a gap between the abdominal piece and the chest piece. So glue in those little recessed parts we cut out to then stick the lower part of the chest onto. Make sure one side is completely set before you do the other side. And then once you've done the other side, put some glue in between the chest and the abdomen, and then push it down and hold it down until it's completely set. This is quite a big seam. It took a good few minutes for this to completely set. Any glue that seeps out, you can use a bit of scrap foam to just scrape that away before it is completely set, and then continue holding that down. Once that's finished, you can seal this with a heat gun, and then it's ready to paint. So painting same as before, three parts silver to one part black, soft bristle brush, make sure you go on all the edges too. And I did three light coats of this silver and black mixed paint. Try and keep all your brush strokes going the same way. And then the whole thing was sealed with that clear lacquer. Onto the weathering, and I weather after it's lacquered because you can always wipe it away. Whereas if you haven't lacquered it, you'll end up wiping the silver paint away as well. So this is a little bit of brown, a little bit of black paint mixed together with a bit of water, and using that same soft bristle brush, you just dab that on in all of the recessed areas, and using some tissue, wipe it away. Now make sure you wipe away from the edge so that the paint stays in the recessed area. If you wipe the other way, you'll end up taking too much off. This is toilet paper I'm using. I find that kitchen roll is too stiff and it doesn't get into all the little nooks and crannies as well. So same again with that mud horn signet, lots of paint and water mixture all over that, and then wiping away from it to keep as much of that paint as you can in those grooves and those little recessed areas, because that's where dirt and grime would naturally build up if this arm was used for real. Exactly the same process with the chest, same paint mixture to get the weathering consistent. Apply that in all of the recessed areas and wipe away with a piece of tissue. If you get too much on that you're not happy with, you can use a wet rag or a baby wipe or something to wipe away all of the weathering effect, and it'll leave you with that lacquered silver finish, and you can just reapply it until you're happy.
Here are these pieces all finished. Got two shoulders and a chest. I'll show you some close-up shots of these now, just so you can see the weathering effect there a bit better. So there you go, as you can see, the weathering on these is very, very subtle. The idea is to make these look like they are indestructible. They're not damaged, they're just dirty. Although you may have noticed in those close-up shots that the left shoulder is indeed damaged because some idiot didn't put it away in the suitcase carefully enough, and that got squished in a bit. But I could just print out some more templates and make a new one in next to no time. Speaking of templates, if you want to make your own, head on over to the Facebook group, the Perfectly Imperfect Makers Community. Check out the files section where you'll find the templates for the helmet and also for the chest and shoulders, and I'll be uploading the other templates as I progress along with this video series. Speaking of, the next video is going to be the forearms, so the whistling bird and the, don't know, the flamethrower slash whatever else he has on the right forearm, grappling hook type stuff. They're next, they're going to be the next video, so make sure you have subscribed to this channel and hit the little notification bell to keep an eye out for that. And that's it, I guess. Yeah, this is quite a straightforward, easy build, and that is because you don't have to be great at making to make something great. Bye bye.